NAS is a critical component to support all my devices at home. At its most basic form, it's just another simple computer on your network you leave on 24/7. I use it to automatically back up important files, save large video projects, use it as a centralized location to store and stream my media files over Plex to my TVs, and to run server applications to operate continuously throughout the day. For years, I've used a NAS that I built from some spare computer parts that I had laying around, but this DIY route can be a little advanced for some users, and is a bit larger and more power hungry than I would like. So instead, I'm going to try a pre-built NAS, the Synology DS418 Play. Going the Synology route is definitely a smaller and simpler build to put together. The disk station user interface is really easy to get everything configured and running, and there are a variety of easy to install applications to add additional support for cloud syncing, email servers, and even video surveillance storage. While it will also work as a Plex media server if you're direct playing videos, software transcoding is limited with the slow Intel Celeron CPU, but alternatively, you could just use Synology's DS Video Player and take advantage of its hardware transcoding. Hi, I'm David, and here are my thoughts on the Synology DS418 Play. Full disclaimer, this hardware was provided to me for testing. First, let's quickly take a look at the hardware of the Synology DS418 Play. This NAS has 4 drive bays, but I'm currently only populating it with 3 10TB Seagate Iron Wolf drives. One of the best features with the Synology NASes is their Synology Hybrid RAID that provides both data protection and flexible expansion when upgrading in the future. In this configuration, I have access to 20TB of storage with one drive used as redundancy. So if one of the drives happens to fail, I'll be protected and still have access to all my files. Also, since I still have an extra drive bay available, in the future if I need to add more storage, I can just populate it with another 10TB or larger drive, and the Synology Hybrid RAID will automatically expand and protect all the drives from a single disk failure. Looking at the rest of the hardware on the NAS, inside you'll find an Intel Celeron J3355 CPU, 2GB of system memory that can be expanded up to 6GB with another memory module. On the front you'll have basics such as a power button, USB 3.0 port, drive access indicator, and locking mechanisms on all the drive bays to keep from accidentally pulling them out. On the back is another USB 3.0, Kensington lock, 2 network ports for either link aggregation or failover support, but in my testing I just used one of the gigabit LAN ports, and saw consistent read and write transfers with my large video files that pretty much saturated the gigabit network line. And finally, on the back you have 2 fans to keep everything cool. Noise from the fans was pretty quiet during my typical use, but hard drive noise is noticeable through the case with these faster spinning, larger multi-platter drives. So be sure to consider where you're placing the device to avoid sound sensitive areas with this setup. The next best thing about the Synology NAS is the super easy to use Disk Manager OS. It has a very similar feel to using an operating system, kind of like Windows 10, but you access it over your web browser. The first time you boot up, it automatically installs and updates, with a basic wizard guiding you through the initial configuration, and shortly after, your NAS is ready to use as a network storage device. Configuring basic things in Disk Manager is super simple as well. Add shared folders to organize all your files, or even encrypt folders. Add and manage user accounts with permissions to specific folders. Configure the Quick Connect feature so you can connect to your NAS from anywhere with an internet connection. Set up notification services to receive alerts on the status of your NAS. Schedule tasks. And there's a lot more that can be configured, but the Synology Knowledge Database does a pretty good job on describing all the features and how to set them all up. The Package Center is pretty much the app store for Synology. From here, there's a variety of different applications you can easily install to add additional features to your NAS. Applications for automatic backup to the cloud or other NASs, utilities for a mail server or IP camera storage. But the main applications I use on this NAS are Plex, DS Video Station, and Docker. DS Video Station is Synology's own application for streaming media files from your NAS to your various devices locally or over the internet. Very similar to Plex, it allows you to access movies, TV shows, and any other videos, automatically organized with episode metadata and thumbnails. Video Station can also take advantage of the hardware transcoding capabilities of the CPU to transcode 4K H.264 or H.265 media files to devices up to 1080p max. For the most part, DS Video Station works well as a media server. The only main limitations I notice are it doesn't support transcoding the odd audio source such as DTS or Dolby True HD, and any H.265 10-bit files can't be hardware transcoded either. But if you stick to direct playing without transcoding, or only transcode H.264 or H.265 files, you should be fine. Alternatively, Plex is the other popular application for organizing and streaming your media files that can be manually installed on the NAS. And I personally prefer to use it over DS Video Station, since it does a better job with generating the right metadata and thumbnails for movies automatically, and the user interface does a better job displaying TV show episodes you're currently watching, or newly added media up front with the on-deck home screen. The one downside though is that currently with the free public version of Plex Media Server, it doesn't support hardware transcoding, and the CPU on the NAS is too slow for most transcoding tasks. It's fast enough for audio transcoding to support those DTS or Dolby audio files, but it's barely fast enough for 1080p H.264 or H.265 video files. So anything beyond that is pretty much out of the question. But if you're just direct playing all your media files to devices that natively support your files, everything will work perfectly fine. Docker is the last application I use, but just as a warning, it isn't actually officially supported on this model. I was able to manually install it, and it seems to work perfectly fine so far for my basic containers, but no guarantees without official support. Overall, the Synology DS418 Play is a solid NAS solution. Easy to use, small footprint, power efficient, and lots of easy to install apps to add various server functionality. Perfect for anyone who wants a simple drop-in solution for centralizing files at home, or as part of a backup strategy. It does also work as a media server with transcoding support if you use the DS Video Station application, or Plex also works too, but it's best to stick to compatible files so everything plays directly. And while the DIY route is still a good option if you need to build a more powerful NAS, already have some parts laying around, and don't mind spending more time tinkering to get everything up and running, for those who just want a NAS and get up and running as quickly as possible, the Synology DS418 Play is probably the better recommendation. But hope you guys enjoyed this one. You know what to do, and I'll see you in the next video.